What if I told you I couldn't stay? Take me or leave me. You can still walk away. Before we get into the video, I just wanted to share the sponsor of this video, Ana Luisa. I'm officially a brand ambassador for Ana Luisa, and I'm so excited because it is a sustainable jewelry brand that really aligns with my values. They release their jewelry in small batches every Friday so as to reduce waste, and they use recycled materials like recycled gold so that they're not part of the gold mining industry. So that's some really great things about them. I just wanted to share the products that I've received from them. This is called the Michelle Signet Ring, and it's really such a pretty ring. It's a bulkier one, and it comes with a malachite stone, and I just think it's so beautiful and such a strong piece. Another piece that I'm wearing from them is this bracelet. This is called the Elijah Bold. I think these are unisex as well. A man can definitely wear these as well, so if you want to get one for your partner or if you're a man yourself, I definitely would recommend this one. It's so pretty. It comes with a chain so it's adjustable, and again the gold plating is super sturdy, and it just really makes it feel like it's a $300 piece, even though this one's currently going for $53. This is the Michelle set, and the thing I love about Ana Luisa's necklace sets is that they don't come attached like in one. They come with three separate necklaces, so it's like getting three necklaces in one. And these are so beautiful as well. I've been wearing them both separately but also together, and girl, I really am just feeling myself in these. They're also really easy to care for, and like most gold-plated jewelry, they do recommend that you take them off before sleeping and before showering, don't wear them into the pool, etc. Anyway, I want to thank Ana Luisa so much for sponsoring this video. If you liked any of these pieces, you can check them out in the link in the description box, where I also have a 10% off discount code for y'all. So let's get on to the video.
What if I told you I couldn't stay? Take me or leave me. You can still walk away. What if I told you this love won't be easy? Will you still be here? Is this real? Will you still be here? If I say how I feel, I don't want to.
Okay, cornpop, sit. Good boy. Good boy. You're such a good boy. Hey everyone, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Rachel, and I am a lifestyle YouTuber who focuses on career, professionalism, beauty, fashion, just really whatever piques my interest. So I'm just going to be recording a work day in my life today. I work in Washington, D.C. I've lived and worked there for about 3 years now, and I love it so much. And I'm a digital organizer at a progressive nonprofit. So I work like all things digital basically. It's a lot of fun, and it's something that I didn't picture myself in when I graduated college as a political science major. But here I am, I love it, and I just wanted to bring you guys along. But yeah, I'm just gonna get ready a little bit. I typically, probably twice a week I get ready, but I'm gonna get ready today because it does make me feel better. And the next 2 weeks are gonna be super important in my career progression and everything, and I just kind of want to feel like on and put together. Yeah, so I just put on some of the Ordinary's moisturizer, and I'm just really gonna keep it light today. I'm gonna do my eyebrows, but yeah, I don't know about you, but just like, I don't know, having jewelry on, doing my nails, just has me feeling so much more put together, especially since I'm wearing like glorified pajamas all day.
What if I told you I couldn't stay? Take me or leave me. You can still walk away. What if I told you
this love? You girls ready? Let's head downstairs get on our computer. So I'm currently in my office. I work with, I'll just show you the setup. So I work in a little room that's all mine. This is where Cornpop sits.
And I have a little view.
Sometimes there's like deer back there or groundhogs, and it's just so relaxing. But yeah, this is where I'm sitting. I'm gonna start working. The first thing I typically do, especially at the start of the week, is I go through my Outlook and I go through my Slack to see if I got any messages over the weekend and to just add those to my work, to my to-do list, basically. I also use Notion. It's one of my favorite apps to like manage my workday and also my personal life. And I'm sure y'all have heard about it by now, but it's the best. So what I'm gonna do is show you kind of what's up. So typically, like, this is what my week looks like. I'll usually go into Outlook and see like what I have going on, if I have any urgent messages to respond to. Yeah, I'll just show you guys what I'm up to. So I know that there's a few things I have to do today. It's Tuesday. Wow. So I know I have to respond to finance over an invoice, update digital databases, I have to connect with my fellow. My fellow is like kind of an intern, I guess. It's someone there that's like to learn, but also is helping out. They're paid, of course. Type out progression document. So the progression document I'll talk about a little bit later, but there's some big changes coming to my team, and I have like a lot of upcoming stress about like growing my personal professional growth, what I want to do with that. I have to do a lot of thinking about that, and it gets me anxious, but I'm gonna put on my list today to work on. Oh, and I'll probably check in a few minutes before my meeting, but I'm gonna go through my Outlook and Slack right now. This is just the stuff I knew off the top of my head. But yeah. Okay, so my meeting's about to start, and I already have two updates. My boss's boss just emailed me, which kind of has to do with what's going on in the next few weeks that I'll be talking about a little bit later. But yeah, he's like, got time to talk today. Does anyone else get super anxious when like a boss or a manager is like, hello, or like, can I call you? I'm like, oh my God, they're gonna fire me. They're gonna fire me right now. And I've actually been working on that with my therapist because I get so anxious and it's almost like debilitating. But I know that this isn't what that call's about, thinking about to fire me. But yeah, I'm kind of interested to see what he has to say. And then I have my call in 1 minute. I also made Cornpop his breakfast, or food, I don't know, breakfast. Anyway, so I'm meeting with I'm gonna be back on camera in a little while after. My meeting's from 9:35, which is right now, to 10, and then I'm meeting with him from 10 to 10:30. So yeah, gotta go. Okay, so I just got off my call with my boss's, the manager's boss. It was a good call. So basically, my manager is leaving for another place. I am honestly devastated. She was, like, I think I said this before, she was an amazing manager. She, like, I would suggest something and she would tell me it's a great idea, or she'd give me like adjustment help. And she kind of just let me do it. And she like believed in me. She thought I had good ideas. She was always like trying to help me. And she was always, you know, telling me to, you know, what I needed to learn to progress, like if I needed any professional development to go take it, because she wants me to progress. And, you know, I don't know, I feel like at previous jobs it's always been kind of like stay down. Here she was like very much like rise up, you can grow here, and you know, you can progress and you can get professional development and you can be a manager and you can do this and you can become a director eventually. And she was always just so great, whatever. Anyway, so she's leaving and I'm super stressed about it. First, because I have to like make money moves now. Like the boss and I were talking like about what we envision my department, and particularly my work, looking like in the next few years. And it's a lot of growth and it's gonna be a lot more intense. It's gonna be a lot more work and potentially like a lot of some new hires, me maybe managing people, I don't know. But my manager told me like, don't be afraid to ask for money now, don't be afraid to ask for you know, job growth. And so I'm going to try to use this opportunity to progress my career, to, you know, maybe take a higher level role, and just kind of assert what this program is going to look like now that I'm kind of the only one working on it. And that's always been something I've been afraid of, just because of the vibe my old managers would give me. It was kind of like, stay down, don't sit at the table with us, kind of thing. And now, like, I'm being encouraged to, like, take my seat at the table and to, you know, fight for what I want. And it's so empowering. I got my coffee, by the way, in this little cup. But yeah, like, I need to, I'm a person who, like, tends to self-sabotage. So, like, I hold myself back with my own anxiety, and I've been working on that with my manager a lot, actually. She and I have been, not my manager, my therapist. My therapist and she knows I have, like, imposter syndrome. I feel like I don't belong there. I feel like, I don't know, they're gonna find out that I'm not as good as I actually think I am. And my therapist has really helped me to remember that I do deserve to be there, that I did do the work that got me to this place, and that I can really do anything I believe in just because of my track record in the past. I am very effective. I am a good worker, and I have to constantly be telling myself these reaffirming thoughts because of the, like, negative thoughts I have. So yeah, just, I need to be brave enough to ask for what I want, and I'm gonna be focusing on that in the next 2 weeks. I'm gonna try to ask for a salary raise, and I'm gonna try to ask for a higher position, a more senior position, and I'm going to ask for either someone to manage or another colleague to help me with this work that I'm gonna be doing. And I'm just saying that to you guys because I want to remember to bring this up with my boss and my manager, and just make it like I don't want to look back at this video when I'm editing it and be like, oh, I didn't ask for those things. I want to make sure I ask for those things, and I want to, like, encourage you guys to do that. I've been, ever since I got this job, I've been so much better about asking for what I want, for what I need, and thankfully I work at a place that encourages that behavior. Yeah, I'm just excited. Anyway, so I'm having coffee and this nutrition shake right now. I have mysteriously low B level sometimes, and so this helps. So while I drink my coffee and this, I'm going to prepare some documents for the coming week that I need to update. I've got a few emails I have to check. Anyway, yeah, so my manager just slacked me and she said, happy to chat with you today, but let me know if there's anything regarding your role that I can advocate for as I transition out. I want to be your partner in any requests or ideas as best I can. So, I'm gonna miss her, but that's just so helpful, and I'm gonna try to connect with her and, like, make clear to her the things that I just told y'all. So, we'll see. But anyway, now I'm just going to work on updating some documents, like I said, and crossing a few things off my checklist that I need to get done. So, off I pop. What is up, y'all? So I have been working on this document about what I envision my job to look like. Digital organizing manager. Let's see. But I'm gonna have lunch, actually, right now. I have pupusas and a tomato slice because I don't have any of the pupusa tomato sauce. I think these are, like, revuelta, which is pork and beans and cheese and lots of other things. Delicious. But yeah, I'm just gonna eat and actually watch The Bachelor while I eat. And then I'm gonna go back to work. But that's the update. Hello, so I am back. I have my, second to last meeting of the day with a, like, digital vendor, someone that used to run one of our databases. We're actually leaving them for every action. So just gonna have a meeting with them and kind of let them know why we're leaving and all that stuff. And then afterwards, I'm actually meeting with my manager to discuss the next steps and the progression, my role's progression, all that stuff. I don't know what I'm doing. My dog's been sleeping like all day. He's just lying there next to me. He's so old and cute. Anyway, my call starts in a minute, so I will report back soon. Okay, so I just got off the phone off that meeting and then took Cornpop for a walk. He's literally just been resting there like all day, just napping. Whoop, my phone. And it's so cute. I love him so much. But yeah, I next have a call with my manager to talk about next steps concerning everything that I've told you about so far. I like wrote down a whole list of everything that I want to do in my role and what I envision my department turning into. Look, he follows me. So I'm really interested in discussing her with that. And I'm gonna do my best to ask for the things that I mentioned earlier. So we'll see what happens. I'm just gonna sit on my couch for a little while. Oh. Does anyone else crash like around 2 p.m.? Because I'm feeling that right now. Anyway. Hello. So my workday is basically done. It's like a little bit after 5. Jake just came home from work, and we're gonna head to go get dinner soon at a nearby brewery where they let you bring outside food. I think we're gonna get some pizza, and we're gonna bring our baby, Cornpop. But my last call was actually so good, like the one with my manager. We had like a 45 minute talk where I just kind of covered like what I would be doing at the organization after she left, which is basically 3 jobs. Or I told her I want to eventually make it into 3 jobs with me eventually leading the other 2 jobs. And so I was just very direct with her what I want to see happen in the future and what she can help me advocate for. She told me like very aggressively, like, ask for more money, ask for what you need. I basically asked, you know, like, I want a more senior position, I'm gonna want more money, I want more help with this program. We're gonna see what happens, but over the next 2 weeks there's gonna be a lot of discussions with my boss and within the team. But it's been overall a good day. I feel really empowered to, you know, say what I mean and like say what I want. And that's always a good feeling to have, especially, it's not always been that way for me. So I'm just really grateful. But I'm gonna look at nearby pizza places where I can order and hopefully get my little hands on some pizza. And yeah, I'm just so grateful for the place I work just because like Jake just came home and he's having a little bit of a hard time at his job. But yeah, just grateful. Let me know if you have a good relationship with management. I've definitely been on both sides and I definitely have some tips. So let me know if you, you know, need those. Hey everyone, so Jake and I ended up having dinner and it's now 10:36 and I'm gonna go to bed. I just walked Cornpop for a few minutes and yeah, I'm tired, so I'm gonna go to bed. Yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you related to it, and I hope that you found it interesting. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'd also just love to hear what you thought about the video. And it'd be great if you could like it and comment as well, or like it and subscribe. Thank you, bye. Hi everyone, thanks for watching this video. I just wanna remind you to check out the link in the description to check out Ana Luisa's jewelry items. Again, I really love the brand and I know you will too. There's a 10% off link in the description, so go ahead and click on that. Thanks everyone, bye.